You headbangers.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for coming tonight. Those two tunes, brand new off the press. First tune called so far anyway, but it's getting used to it. It's a great title, first tune of the set. Second tune's called Slag. The Slag. You know, hoping, you know, it's kind of slagging along. I don't know, even know what it means. But we're going to do a tune now, also kind of a new one, very new actually, named after a beautiful lady. You see her right before your eyes. See, I know how to get inside, you know. Got to write a tune for him or you're done for. But she is a beautiful lady, and she sounds great on this. This is called Adina. Thank you. Adina. Okay, you've been a pretty good audience, I must say. So we're going to do a special thing for you. This guy only comes out for really, really, really special occasions. And since we're recording tonight and videoing and you can see and hear your hands on the record, we're going to pull him out for this tune. His name's Randroid, and he wrote this tune, not me. So don't blame me, baby. Don't blame me. Back in 1971, and I recently found the words and kind of rearranged everything to kind of suit these surroundings. So this is a tune featuring Randroid called Really Info It. Near the door, when I spied my lady careening across the floor, she weren't in a mood for talking. This I could plainly see. There was fire in her eyes, and they was pointed straight at me. I said, uh-oh, I'm in for some shit. I said, uh-oh. You. I say, hey, mama, hey, what's wrong with you? She don't say nothing, not nada. I'm in for some shit. She don't say nothing, not nada. I'm really in for it out. Address from Gay Perry, written on pink paper, smelling like some lingerie. What was in this letter? I did not have to read. I figure I better escape now before I start to bleed. I say, Lord, uh-oh, uh-oh, my shit just hit the fan. I say, uh-oh, uh-oh, it means time to scram. Move now, out came the knife. I said, mama, let's talk this over before you take my life. She weren't in the mood for talking, just kept fingering that blade. I didn't see no way out now, so I knelt down and prayed. I said, Lord, uh-oh, Lord, uh-oh, please save my ass. Lord, uh-oh. From her purse, I slipped a note. I grabbed that piece of paper, figured it was my only hope. It read, my dearest darling lady, when can we elope? And in her handwriting, as soon as I get rid of this dope, now she cried, uh-oh, uh-oh, yeah, I done pulled the switch. She cried, uh-oh, uh-oh, cause I'm gonna kill the bitch. Thank you. rest of the story. Then we look right in each other's eyes. The knife dropped to the floor. We said, goddamn, what are we doing? Let's both go out and score. Turn round to the party, a hustle on to the floor. And from that day on, there was peace at home. To hell with the goddamn wars. No more uh-ohs, no uh-ohs. Gonna uh-oh no more. No more uh-ohs, no uh-ohs. Gonna both go out and score. No more uh-ohs, no uh-ohs. Gonna have a good time, no uh-ohs. No uh-ohs, gonna drink some wine. Come on, you got it, short, short, you got it, baby. He's crawling back under a rock right now. Okay, no Brecker Brothers band reunion would quite be complete with, of course, without paying tribute to the late, great Michael Brecker. We miss him a lot, but we still have his music to carry on, right? And we're going to do one of his most popular tunes, one we love to play. Often he didn't like to play this one because he didn't like to play any of his stuff or hear anything he ever did, or he didn't, you know. But this is a great tune. It's a title tune from our sixth record in the 80s, 1982. It's called Strap Hangin', Strap Hangin'. Thank you. Michael Brecker, strap hanging. We love you. Well, welcome to the Blue Note, New York City, Brecker Brothers Band Reunion. Brecker Brothers Band Reunion. All these guys played with the band one time or another. We'll introduce them later, but we're just having a ball this week. We'd like to thank again your presence here. I know, as you know, we're recording, so your hands are going to be on the record. But you got to clap. All right, we love it. This tune, though, is written in honor of our two-year, eight-month-old daughter, Stella. We call this one Stellina.
Thank you.
Delina. Okay, you're getting a bunch of specials tonight, because we have another special treat for you. This is a young gentleman who's going up in the world, and he co-wrote a tune with Ara Rovati, and I heard it, and I said, oh, we got to do that tune, and invite him up, because he's just a wonderful performer from London, England. Let's welcome to the stage. You're going to hear a lot more about Mr. Ali Rockburger. Ali Rockburger. And this is a tune called Murray Go Town by Ali and Ada.
Round. keeps in my lonely mind. I see they're getting in fights, they're running red lights and writing on the walls of my inside.
Thank you, Blue Note. Thank you.
Whoa! Ollie Rockburger. Man. Ollie Rockburger. Get his autograph now, because in 6 months you're going to have to go through bodyguards. Well, we just had a great time playing tonight. Before we play the last one, I wanted to briefly introduce everyone. You know who everybody is, but we literally have been playing together for many years. This is actually the first time this incarnation of Brecker Brothers Reunion Band transpired. Different guys played with the band at different times, so this is really a treat for all of us. I want to go all the way back to the person I first met many years ago, back in 1970, when before Brecker Brothers, when we had a band called Dreams, my brother and I, we needed a bass player. We were signed to Columbia Records, and a friend of mine, Gary Campbell, said, "Why don't you call this guy? He's in Miami, Fort Lauderdale. He's only 17, but why don't you call him?" So I did. I gave him a call. He flew up, and he played for about 20 seconds, and we said, "You got the gig." Never went back to Miami. Now he's played with just everyone under the sun, under the world, in the world, out of the world. You see your records. He's on the Dave Letterman show. He's part of the Fab Four. And literally, he's played with everyone. Mr. Will Lee. Yeah, baby. I should have got a percentage, but who knew? He was old. Damn, screwed up again. Next in line, we met in the early 80s. He was playing his behind off in Boston. I went to a small club, and he was there, and I was blown away. His name preceded him, and he went on to also worldwide fame, playing with Miles Davis, and then later, of course, steps ahead in his own bands. Well, I've been happy enough to tour the world with him the last couple of years, and Mr. Dave Weckl over here. But his name is Mike Stern on guitar. You know him, Mike Stern. Yeah, funny how these things come together. A couple of years later, a young drummer came to town from St. Louis. People started talking. He just took the town by storm. Now he's taking the world by storm. You also know him, I would think. He's played with just everyone, Chick Corea, his own bands. I could go on and on and on. But you know, Mr. Dave Weckl. And over here to my right is probably one of my newest acquaintances. We go back a bunch of years now to probably 1992. A drummer named Joel Rosenblatt said, "Hey, there's this keyboard guy, and he's also a good producer. Why don't you call him?" So I said, "Well, I remembered Will Lee, and that worked out." So I gave George a call, and he went on to play and produce the two Brecker Brothers records of the 90s, and also a lot of my solo records and a lot of Michael Brecker solo records, and he's just lent a hand to the latest Herbie Hancock record, moved out to L.A. and cleaning up out there. At least cleaning the streets, at least. Don't get it wrong. Now, he's doing quite well in L.A. Let's hear it for the man behind the scenes, the man in front of the scenes, the one and only Mr. George Whitty. Yeah. Whoa. Too much. Last but not least, the lady in the hot seat, and what a job she's doing. All right. Let me say, this is no easy task, and she is from Mortara, Italy, small town Took up the saxophone kind of late in life, but was really attracted to it, practiced real hard, very studious. So, and look what happened. So her name is Ada Rovati. Adina. We love her. Too much. Okay, we do have one more tune for you, and this is a tune from a record we did with Brecker Brothers Band, probably our biggest seller. It was called Heavy Metal Bebop, and it was a blues on this record that we're going to perform. Now, Heavy Metal Bebop, by the way, was voted number one jazz horn record, not even jazz, just horn record in Japan. I just saw it, I think. Number one. Number two, I think this was the only time it was number two, was Kind of Blue, but Heavy Metal Bebop was number one, and this is a tune called Inside Out that features everyone in the band. Once again, we love you. We thank you for coming. Inside Out.
Thank you.
one more time for Dave Wacko, Mike Stearns, Will Lee, George Whitty, Otto Robati, Randy Brecker, Brecker Brothers Band Reunion. We thank you so much. You've been a beautiful audience. Thank the Blue Note, Jeff Levinson. Thanks for having us. Good night. CDs. Uh-oh. Okay, we'll see if the schedule can hold this. We're gonna play a tune as fast as is humanly possible. That was it, thank you. This tune was written after I visited a young lady who had a pet skunk in her back room, believe it or not. And I said to myself, that's some skunk funk. And I had to write a tune about it. So a couple of years later, I did, and we've been playing it ever since. So this is As Fast As Is Humanly Possible, played some skunk funk. Skunk Funk. One more time for Will Lee, Mike Stern, Dave Weckl, George Whitty, Ara Robati, Randy Brecker, the old guy. Brecker Brothers Band Reunion, thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, please feel free to join us upstairs.